Hey everyone, welcome back. Are you the type of person who loves the look of real life, but doesn't actually want to experience it? Well, if that's the case, this video could be just for you, because today we're looking at texture packs. Yes, that's right. Today we are looking at texture packs. If you've ever loaded up Minecraft and punched a tree, but it just doesn't feel real enough, then this video might be for you. People have been modding Minecraft and adding their own textures since even before the game was released for sale to the public. When Minecraft was still in beta, there was already a modding scene. So, fast forward to 2022 and we've got Java Edition, Bedrock Edition, Pocket Edition, all of which you can add resource packs that will replace the textures in your game. But what does a texture pack even do? Any 3D model in a video game will have a 2D texture applied to its exterior that gives it color and detail. The default resolution of Minecraft is 16 by 16 pixels, and that's what gives it its charm. But additional texture packs can increase them to 1024 by 1024 pixels, which has nearly 5,000 times the number of pixels as native. That is a lot of numbers, but essentially what it means is that with the right texture pack and the right hardware, you can get some really sharp visuals in your game. Some texture packs also change other aspects of the game, like menus and loading screens, which can make the experience even more immersive. If you use some of the texture packs in conjunction with one of the shaders from this video, you can get some crazy results. As always, finding these packs for Minecraft Education Edition isn't always as simple as it is on other editions of the game. Not to worry though, as I have been scouring the internet to bring you 6 different texture packs that are easy to download and install. I'm running these texture packs today in 1.17 version of Minecraft Education Edition on a Windows machine. Links to the downloads and credit to the original channel creators will be in the video description below. And I'll also add timestamps to help you find the parts of the video you are looking for. Now, each of the texture packs featured in today's video excels in a different area, so make sure you do check out the full video so you can see which one is for you. I will be showing footage of each texture pack in a range of different conditions and comparing them one at a time to the vanilla game. I'll show all the textures in today's video with shaders. And at the end of today's video, I'll show how to download and install every texture pack in today's video. Please do go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button, but without any further ado, here is the 6 best texture packs for Minecraft Education Edition 1.17 approved. We'll be right back. All right, guys, I'm going to activate shader now with the various different texture packs that we've already looked at. This is the RWSPE shader from last week's video. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. You can go into the resource pack and activate both resource packs at once, that's fine. Do be forewarned that it's quite intensive on your computer. So if your computer blows up, don't blame me, but let's go ahead and take a look at the results. Alright guys, we're going to now look at how to download some of these texture packs. I have chosen ones that I think are quite easy to download. It's just one of them that's got a few extra steps in it than normal. Also, these have been scanned with an antivirus and they all came back fine, so you can trust in that. I am using Google Chrome to download all of these, so let's dive in and take a look.
Dokucraft is the first one we'll look at. Follow the link in the description, click here for Minecraft Bedrock Edition. And then down in the bottom left here, your download file will be there. Easy. Vipul R50, link in the description to MCPEDL. Scroll down, download the MC pack file there. Click to continue. And once you've clicked this one, just wait. Let it count down, don't click anywhere else. And then click skip add. Same here, just wait. Don't click anywhere, don't do anything. And then it will redirect you here, say click this link. And then there you are, there's your download. Just be patient on that one, don't click anywhere you shouldn't. And there it is, down at the bottom is our texture pack. Firewolf is the next one. Link in the description, just there where it says download Bedrock texture pack. There it is. And there's our download, bottom left, just open that in Minecraft Education and it'll be in your resource files. Depixel, for the link, click there. And then we want to get the Bedrock LITE. That one's important. And there we are, there's the MC pack file. Open that up. Zedercraft, this one's a little bit different, but it's worth it. It's well worth it. Let's zoom in and take a look. So we want to download the Windows 10 Bedrock Edition. Click continue. And then click download. There's our file. Now here's what we have to do with this file. It's a little bit different. So there it is, it's a zip file. Okay, so we can't just open it directly with Minecraft Education Edition. We're going to open up a Windows File Explorer. We're going to go to our local disk and to users. We're going to select whoever you are, the user that you are, logged in as, and then to go to app data. Now, if you can't see app data, go to view and select hidden items. You can see that there. If I deselect it, it disappears. Hidden items selected. And there it is, app data. Go to roaming. Go to Minecraft Education Edition, then we're going to head to Games, Mojang, and then Resource Packs, and then extract that zip file and chuck it in there and it will come up. All right, it's worth it, that one. The new Wayukian, I don't know if that's I'm saying that. Easy, click, there you go. Follow the link, click there, and it will just click continue. And it will just download, and again, it's a zip file. So if you want to use this one, you need to chuck it in there.
All right, everyone, I hope you enjoyed looking at those shaders together today. I'm sure you all agree that they each add something quite special in their own rights, and they do change the feel of the game. And do leave a comment down below letting me know which one was your favourite. Now, the plans for the channel over the next few weeks, we're going to have some more mods coming your way. And I'm going to be uploading them over the next few weeks. You must please do like and subscribe down below to make sure you don't miss any of those. But I will see you all next week.